Hello, students. Welcome to another English lesson. I have a special English lesson for you today because we are going to be looking at some essential everyday slang. So, I know a lot of my students are studying to pass an exam or maybe you want to work in an English-speaking company or you want to go to a school in an English-speaking country, but I think if you want to communicate with people in English, you need to know some essential slang words. So these might not be in your textbooks. You might have never learned these words before, but they are important because lots of people use them every day, okay? So before we get into today's lesson, if you haven't yet, and you would like to know when I go live, when I post new videos, if you could, please subscribe to the YouTube channel, turn on notifications, and that way you should be notified when I go live and stuff like that. However, YouTube doesn't always send out notifications, so if you come back regularly, you'll see when new lessons are posted too. You can follow me on Facebook as well. Same deal over there. Like, follow, and I think you can turn on notifications there too. I'm also on TikTok, so you can find me there as well. Okay, now that we got that out of the way, let's get into the lesson. All right, so I'm gonna pull up my screen. Da, 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 da. Okay, we have essential everyday slang. Okay, so this slang is what you're going to need to know for just everyday communication, right? And this is American English. Please remember that I am from the United States and that my accent and the slang that I use is all like North American. Okay, excellent. Let's get in. We have 11 slang words that we're going to learn today. 11. Okay, so the first one we have is hang out, hang out. So hopefully you know this or you've heard this before. It means spending time relaxing or socializing informally, okay? So you can hang out with your friends, you can hang out with your brother or your sister. It's just a very relaxed atmosphere. You might not even be doing anything, but just talking or watching TV. That is what we call hanging out, okay? So my example sentence for this one, do you wanna hang out after you're done with work? Do you wanna hang out after you're done with work? You will hear this a lot if you go to America or Canada, maybe even in the UK, I'm not really sure, but hang out just means to casually meet and, you know, spend some time together. So let me know in the comments, you can comment down below, who do you like to hang out with? I like to hang out with my husband. I also like to hang out with my really good friends. It's been difficult due to the current state of the world, but I do like to hang out with my friends. Recently, we've been hanging out on Zoom calls. Let me know who you hang out with. Okay, the next one is amped, amped. So, you might not have heard this word before, or you might have heard it in the proper context of the word. So an amp can mean that you amplify something, for example, a sound. If you are going to a live concert, usually they have a speaker connected to maybe like guitar or something, and that will amplify the sound to everyone else in the room. Okay, amp. So in slang, we use amped to mean filled with energetic excitement and enthusiasm. Amped. Okay, so here is the example. I'm so amped for the concert this weekend. Oh, I used concert again here. I'm so amped for the concert this weekend. Okay, I'm always amped for my live English lessons because I get to talk to you. I am very amped every time. Okay, very excited, very enthusiastic. Please let me know when you feel amped. When is a time that you feel amped? I also feel amped when I go on like a stage and speak in front of people. I've had to do that several times in my life, and I feel really amped, really enthusiastic, excited, energetic. Wow, let's do this. Some people in front of people on a stage, maybe they don't feel amped. Maybe they feel very nervous or shy, but I get amped, I think. Okay, the next one. Have a blast. This is a super common expression. This is super, super common in English. So, to have a blast means to have a good time, to enjoy oneself. So, let's look at the example sentence. We had a blast at the beach. So, that means we had a really good time. We had a lot of fun. We had a blast. Okay? When was the last time you had a blast? When was the last time you had fun? Let me think of the last time I had a blast. I had a blast when I played an online game with my friends over Zoom. That was a blast. We had a lot of fun. Okay? Have a blast. So you can say this as like in a sentence, we had a blast at the beach. Or if someone says, I'm going to a party this Friday, your response could be, have a blast. It means have fun. Okay, next one. Hooked on. Hooked on. So if you can imagine a hook, and if it's hooked on something, it's kind of stuck, right? It doesn't really move. It's hooked on. So when you are hooked on something, that means you are very interested and enthusiastic about something. You're hooked on something. You like it a lot. Maybe you can't stop doing it. You're hooked on it, okay? So, she's really hooked on that book. She can't put it down. She's really hooked on that book. Okay, so it's kind of like your interest at the moment, something you're really, really interested in. So, for me, I think right now I'm probably hooked on cameras and filming equipment. I'm really, really interested in it. I am looking up YouTube videos, how to use my new camera. I'm looking up my next camera that I want to buy. I'm hooked on cameras. What are you hooked on? Are you hooked on anything at the moment? Some people are hooked on fishing. Other people are hooked on studying. You could be hooked on a book or on a TV show. Anything that you have interest in. So hooked on something. So usually we would say hooked on plus a noun. So hooked on a book, or you could use a gerund, hooked on studying with an ing. Okay, let me know what you are hooked on down in the comments. Very good. The next one. Very, very simple. The word is in. What? You know that word. Everybody knows that word, in. Okay, but when we're talking about slang, and especially fashion, the meaning is fashionable or trendy. So what are people liking in the moment, like right now? So here is my example sentence. Bell-bottom pants were in when my parents were teenagers. So if you know what bell bottoms are, or bell bottom jeans, bell bottom pants, they're the pants that they have your figure, and then at the leg, they go out and they look like a bell. They look like bells. Bell bottom pants were very big. We can also say big, very trendy. In like the 60s and 70s, I think, probably more the 70s, bell bottom pants were in the 70s. They were big in the 70s. They were trendy. They were fashionable. What is in right now in your country? I think, what is in Japan? So I live in Japan, in Tokyo, if you didn't know that. So what is in right now? I don't think I'm with the current trends, but I think right now the color beige is very in right now, at least in Tokyo. That is really the trendy color of the season is beige. I'm not very fashionable, but maybe you are. Okay, so let me know what is in right now in your country. Okay, the next one, bail. Okay, so to bail, when we're talking about slang, means to cancel or run away from. Okay, so if you bail on someone, or if you bail on an event, that means you cancel suddenly or you kind of run away from something. So it's not really a good meaning. It means that maybe you had an agreement to meet someone or to go somewhere and you just didn't do it. So we hate it when people bail on us, right? It's not a good feeling. So here's an example. We made plans a month in advance, but he bailed on me at the last second. He bailed on me. So even though we made plans months in advance, he still didn't come. Okay, he bailed on me. So we usually say bail on someone or bail on something. Okay, very good. The next one, kind of similar, very similar, is ditch. To ditch someone, okay, or to ditch something. So, meaning again, cancel or run away from. Cancel, run away from. Okay, so ditch is the same meaning as bail. To cancel, to run away from. Okay, so we could say, I can't believe she ditched me to go to that party. So she ditched me, she canceled on me, and went to a party. So to ditch someone, to bail on someone. Okay, very good. Next one, spoiler. This is a very common word, especially online. Okay, so the meaning looks a little long. Let's go through it. I promise it's not that difficult. So the meaning is a description of an important plot development in a television show, film, or book, which, if previously known, may reduce surprise or suspense for a first-time viewer or reader. Okay, so that is a lot of text to simply say that for a movie, a TV show, a book, usually there is a plot. So if you're following the characters, you're following the plot. If you are watching your favorite TV show and your friend has already watched that episode, if they tell you what's going to happen in the episode, they spoiled the episode for you. So we would say they gave you a spoiler. They told you the information that now if you watch your favorite TV show, it's not going to be that exciting. Okay, so a lot of times online, people will say spoiler alert or spoilers if they're going to say something that will spoil the movie or the book or the TV show for you. Okay, so here's an example. If, let's say there is a movie and I want to watch it, you've already watched it. If you say, can I give you some spoilers? I would say, no. I want to watch the movie. Don't tell me anything. Don't give me any spoilers, please. Okay? So don't tell me anything about that movie or that TV show. Okay, let's look at my example here. I can't believe he died at the end of the movie. So person A, I can't believe he died at the end of the movie. Person B, ugh, spoiler! Hey, you just told me what happens in the movie and I didn't see it yet. Ugh, spoiler! So I actually did this a few years ago. I watched a movie. It was a really popular franchise and I watched the movie in the theater with my friends. And I was so shocked because one of the characters died. One of my favorite characters died. And I came out of the movie theater and I was talking with my friends and I said, oh my gosh, I can't believe that character died. I loved that character. And then my friend said, hey, you might want to stop giving spoilers because there was a line of people waiting to go into that movie. I felt so bad. So that's movie etiquette, right? Movie theater etiquette. Don't give spoilers at the theater because you don't know who is going to see what movie, right? Okay, next one. Hit me up. Hit me up. Okay, so hit me up means to contact someone. So it should be really hit someone up. So, I'll hit you up. Can you hit me up? I'll hit her up. I'll hit him up. So, it just means to contact someone, either by text, phone call, like email. Okay? So, the example sentence is, hit me up if you're ever in town. Hit me up if you're ever in town. I'd love to hang out with you. Hit me up if you're ever in town. Okay, very good. So, that one is a pretty simple one, I think. Oh, the next one, FOMO, FOMO. So it is written F-O-M-O, and this is an abbreviation for fear of missing out. So they take the first letter of each of these words, and we created this word, FOMO, FOMO. So FOMO means the fear of missing out. So what FOMO is for example, if your friend invites you to a party, you want to say yes because of your fear of missing out. If I don't go, what will I miss? I might miss some really good conversations, or I might miss seeing some people. It's FOMO, okay? Let's look at the example. My parents won't let me go to the party. I have so much FOMO, okay? So, oh, my parents won't let me go to the party. Now I have FOMO, I have so much FOMO. So now I'm really afraid that I will be missing some great entertainment or conversations or people. Oh, I feel like I'm missing out. Okay? Have you ever felt FOMO before? Have you ever felt like, oh, if I don't go, what am I missing? So I think a lot of people experience that. I don't know if you have a word in your language for that feeling. So this is kind of not an official word, but it's a slang word. But it's what people use when we talk about feeling like left out. Left out. Okay? Next one. Next one is legit. Legit. Okay? So this comes from the word legitimate. But in slang, it means extremely good. Extremely good. For example, if we say, those cupcakes were legit. Those cupcakes were legit. That means they were really, really good. Okay? So if I say, that party last night was legit, it was really good. That concert was legit. That concert was so much fun. It was really good. Okay? Very easy to use. But remember, this is slang, so I wouldn't recommend saying this for any like interview or speaking test. But if you're talking with friends, this is a completely good word to use. This is a legit word to use. Okay, so those were our 11 slang words. I hope you can remember them and use them in English conversation. If you can't remember some of them, maybe go back, watch this lesson again, take some notes, and you can try and use them when you speak to me in the comments. That's totally okay. Or if you have some American English speaking friends, you can use it with them, of course. But yes, I hope this was a helpful and useful lesson for you. Let me know if you have any questions. Don't forget to try and make some sentences using these words in the comments below. I'll be checking them. And good luck with speaking English slang. All right, I'll see you in our next lesson. Bye, everyone.